I think I have something for you, Filmora.
Templates galore, impressing me. Easy duckin, the voice is loud. Music fades out, motion tracking. Colors changing side by side, seamless transitions change that key, and you see how easy it is. Filmora, Filmora, you did it faster. Mac and PC, DMG, or EXE. You can have it all, a one-time fee. Use my link below. You can take it slow. See how it goes with.
So I hope you guys enjoyed that Filmora song. I wrote it and I sent it off to Jasmine Music on Fiverr to come up with the melody. She adapted the lyrics and she made it awesome. Definitely check out Jasmine Music. I'll put her Fiverr page down below if you're interested in hiring her. So let's just go ahead and get into all the good stuff about Filmora. Let's start with who it's for. Filmora is for the online social editor. Somebody that's making quick projects for YouTube, Facebook, TikTok, whatever. It's really easy to use and has everything you need. If you need multiple sequences, more advanced audio correction, more advanced color correction tools, you definitely probably don't want to be using Filmora. There is a Filmora Pro, however, and I did make a full tutorial and review comparing Filmora Pro to Premiere Pro, and you can click on the card above if you want to check that out. As for pricing, Filmora, you can download it for free on both a Mac and a PC, but it will have a watermark on export. If you want to go pro, it's $69.99 once. You don't have to do subscription, which is great. You can, though, get a subscription to their film stock, which allows you to get unlimited stock video, effects, and audio. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into the app and see it up close. First up is importing media. I'm going to import the short clip from a previous tutorial that I made to demo this. Now I'm going to drag this clip into the timeline, and it will ask you if you want to change the timeline settings to the clip settings to match the frame rate and the right resolution. In this case, I will do that, but if you ever need to change it at any time, you can go up to File and Project Settings, and you can change the frame rate and the resolution of your timeline, which is great if you need to do vertical or square videos. Also, I want to mention that with importing media, you can also record your media. So if you need to screen record anything, it comes built in with its own Wondershare screen recorder. So this screen recorder works really well. It has all the things you would need to make a professional screen recording. Number two is playback speed. The playback speed, when you scrub through your timeline or play it back to preview, is so much faster now. In previous versions of Filmora, it was dreadfully slow, and now they have the new GPU acceleration, making it so much better for playback. Also, if you have higher resolutions, like 4K or above, you can reduce the playback resolution to like a quarter or an eighth, so that way you can have better playback speed. If you want to quickly scrub through the timeline, the best way to do that is clicking and holding on the scissors icon and then moving it up and down the timeline. And now let's go on to basic cuts. How do you make a cut inside of Filmora? The cuts are really easy to make. You can just click on the scissors icon to make a split, and then you can press the delete key to delete that excess portion of the clip, and it will ripple delete automatically. If you prefer to use a keyboard shortcut for splitting inside of Filmora, you can go to keyboard shortcuts, and underneath the tools, you can change the split shortcut to something that's more rememberable. In my case, I like to use C for the cut tool, and that's easy for me to remember, so I can just cut and it will make a split for me. And now on to the transform tools. If you double click on a clip in your timeline, it'll bring up a whole new set of edit options. For example, I can scale this video up a bit to crop out the light that's in the shot, and there are many other options here that you can explore. Next is the audio ducking feature. Here you can control the audio levels that are connected with this video clip. The most useful tool here for you is the auto ducking. So to demo this, let's go ahead and let's add a music clip from the music royalty-free library that's here inside of Filmora. I'm just going to drag this audio clip called One More Test into the timeline. When I play it back, you can hear that it's really hard to hear my voice against the music. So if I double click on this clip again and select lower the volume of the other clips, I suggest to have this at mid strength here. And now in the timeline, you can see that Filmora automatically lowered the waveform of the music against the audio. And now let's play it back to see how the ducking works. An easy to use streaming app for content creators that can connect. If you need to make further audio refinements, you can click on the audio mixer icon here on the right, and you can adjust the volume levels of both the voice on the video and the music levels as well. So you get a lot of control here, which is something that I was impressed by inside of Filmora. Next up is color correction. If you select the color tab from the edit controls on your clip and go to advanced, this will bring up a new tab of a bunch of presets that you can choose from. You can try them out and see how they work. I'll try out the Mission Impossible look. I think it looks pretty cool. And then you can go to adjust and make further adjustments to this clip. So for example, we can try out the auto white balance. I think it did a pretty good job. And if you need to, let's say you're filming in a log format, which is a high dynamic range way of shooting, you can actually apply 3D LUTs inside of Filmora, which is pretty advanced. So I was really surprised that they had this in here. In this case, I didn't shoot in log, so I'm just gonna go into the parameters and make some adjustments, such as adding some vibrance to the shot. And you can also make adjustments to the contrast, exposure, whatever you need here. What's really cool is in the upper right, you can actually click on the eye to turn off the color grading that you did to see the before and then the after, or you can select the side-by-side view, which is really cool and an advanced feature that I was not expecting to see inside of Filmora. And of course, the templates, the titles, and all of the openers that you can use, including callouts. So Filmora comes built in with some included titles, lower thirds, all of which that you can customize the font and the color to match your brand. You can also purchase more through the Filmstock subscription. So if you have the subscription to Filmstock, you will be able to download as many of the lower thirds and templates that you want to customize. One thing I wish that these lower thirds and titles did was to be able to customize the background colors. You can adjust the size. It's really easy to do that just by using the transform tools when you're inside of the viewer, but you cannot control the color. That's one thing I would like to see in this app. So I was really surprised that there was motion tracking inside of Filmora. For one, this is a more advanced feature, but they made it really easy to use. Here I have a skateboard clip in my timeline. I'm going to go up to tools to speed and duration and slow it down to about 50% speed. Now I want to track this guy's back because I want to add some animated elements to him as he's skateboarding down this mountain here. So I'm going to double click on the clip and I'm going to go down to motion tracking. And then I'm going to change the center of this tracking area around his back. And you can try out different areas, like you can track his head to see which one works better. So once it's done tracking, then you can go to the elements section inside of Filmora. And let's say you want to add some of these animated wings to the timeline. And now you can see the wings are not attached to him at all. But what you can do is go back to the motion tracking section and choose the layer of the wings that you want the tracking to be attached to. So now the wings, you just have to recenter them on the back and it's fully attached to his back. So if you want to do some cool TikTok effects, some outline effects using these elements, you can use the motion tracking feature to do that. The motion tracking is really powerful because you can attach callouts, you can attach animated elements, and it's really easy to do and it doesn't take a lot of time inside of Filmora to use. Another quick thing I want to mention are the split screens. So you guys know that I've created a whole split screen pack for Premiere Pro that you can use, including 33 different split screens. Well, Filmora has a bunch of different split screen templates already made. You just take the split screen down into your timeline and then drag and drop the videos that you want. The customization of these split screens are a little difficult to control, but if you're fine with the presets, I mean, it's a great way to start your split screens, and there's many different variations to choose from. Of course, there are lots of other different effects you can do, such as removing green screen, cloning effects, adding cool visual effects to your video, and all of that you can go check out on the Wondershare YouTube channel. They have lots of tutorials there. So I just wanted to say that Wondershare Filmora did sponsor this video, but they did not review it. So they gave me full creative freedom to make this video. They're probably gonna be super surprised by the song too, because they had no idea that was happening. I hope you guys like it. So I love sharing different software with you guys. You know, most of the videos I do on this channel are in Premiere Pro in the Adobe Creative Cloud, but a lot of you guys don't wanna have subscription options. And what's really cool about Wondershare is that Filmora, you can buy a perpetual license forever for just $69.99, which is a pretty great deal. And especially for people that are just starting out, I think it's a great way to get started in video editing. Let me know what you guys think. If it helped you out, be sure to give this a big thumbs up. It helps the channel grow. It helps me know if you want more content like this, especially review style content. And also don't forget to hit that notification bell so you can stay notified when I publish new videos on the channel. Anyway, that's all for today's video, and now let's roll the Filmora song.
Filmora, templates galore, impressing me, easy duckin, the voice is loud. Music fades out, motion tracking. Filmora, Filmora, you did it. Fast rendering, you fixed it. Get home in time for dinner. Colors changing, side by side. Seamless transitions, change that key, and you see how easy it is. Filmora, Filmora, you did it. Faster rendering, you fixed it. Get home in time for dinner. Mac and PC, DMG, or EXE, you can have it all, a one-time fee, use my link below. See how it goes with